Good morning, my dear students of class 4. How are you? I hope you all are well and stay in your home. So, today is 18th May 2020 and today is Monday. So, this is my third presentation to you. So, let's start to our geography class and I am your Picon Miss. So, today we start the chapter 5, the Northeastern State. So boys, at first we know what are the states of the Northeastern in our country. So at first you see a map in your first page and you will see there are some states that are Northeast India. And number 1 Arunachal Pradesh, number 2 Assam, number 3 Manipur, number 4 Meghalaya, number 5 Mizoram, number 6 Nagaland, and number 7 Tripura, and the last one is Sikkim. So we know about 8 states of Northeast India very briefly today. Now at first we know a new term, that is Siliguri corridor. What can I say? Siliguri corridor. And you can see the map and you also see that there are some countries, not state, and there is also Nepal, China, Bhutan, India, Bangladesh and Myanmar. And you can also see a arrow that is the Siliguri corridor. So at first we know what is the Siliguri corridor. So boys, Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Tripura, Sikkim are connected to the rest of India by a narrow strip, that is you see in an arrow, that is called the Siliguri corridor in West Bengal. So boys, you already know what are the Siliguri corridor. And next we know that Assam lies on the northern plains while the rest of the northeastern states are covered by the northern mountains. Next you will see a map. There is something different colors and different types of map. So boys, we know that the Eastern Himalayas and Northeast Hills, Patkai, Naga and Lusai define the topography of the Northeastern states. So boys, do you have a knowledge of topography? I think not. So at first we know what is topography. Topography is the study of the land surface. In particular, it lays the underlying foundation of a landscape. For example, topography refers to mountains, valleys, rivers, or craters on the surface. So, boys, you can see the map. There you see something green color, something yellow color, or something brownish. So there we see that something is brown, that is the part of mountains. And when you see a very small line of or a narrow or white line of blue, that is the river. So this is the portion of rivers or valleys, and that is the green color, there is land. So in the topography we know about where the valley, where river, where mountains are situated in a state. So the average elevation from the sea level is up to 7000 meters. The hills are interspersed with valleys and plains. Next we know about the valley of Northeastern states. So boys, you have remembered what is valley. So the Brahmaputra and Barak valley plains are important plains in the Northeastern state. The Imphal Valley, Brahmaputra Valley and Barak Valley are some important valley of the northeastern states. So boys, you can see the picture that number one is Brahmaputra Valley, number two is Barak Valley and the last one is Imphal Valley. Now we shall know the climate of the northeastern states of our country. So these states receive high rainfall, an average of about 10,000 millimeter. So boys, can you imagine? The number is 10,000 millimeter. Though the climate of the lowlands is warm and humid, the higher areas like Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim have snowy winters and mild summers. Mausinram in Meghalaya records the highest rainfall in the world. And boys, you can see a picture in the page that is a thing that covers the whole body of a man. So this is made by Ken, and this is a picture of Mausinram, and there is a highest rainfall receipt. So next we know the wildlife of the northeastern states of our country. There are many thousands of species of flowering plants. The states have many wildlife sanctuaries and national parks to protect and preserve the wild animals in their natural habitats. Now, next we shall know the natural vegetation of the northeastern states of our country. So you can see lots of pictures in this page, and number one is tropical deciduous, and the picture is also the type of tropical deciduous forest. Next one is tropical wet evergreen, then temperate, number four tropical semi evergreen, number five subtropical, and the last one is alpine. So we know the six types of natural vegetation in these states. Now we shall know the economic activities of these states. There rice, maize, chilies, tea and ginger are the main crops grown here. Next, agriculture is the principal activity of the people of this region. Growing fruits, fruit preservation, weaving, handicrafts like pottery, bamboo products and woodwork are some of the other occupations of the people. Next, we know an important thing, that is Tripura is rich in natural gas. So boys, do you know what is natural gas or what is the meaning of natural gas? So I say that natural gas power plant has the natural gas power plants generate electricity by burning natural gas as their fuel. All natural gas plants use a gas turbine. Natural gas is added along with the steam of air, which combusts and expands through this turbine, causing a generator to spin a magnet making electricity. And you can see a picture that is how natural gas made. Next, we know other important things, that is Arunachal Pradesh has hydro power plants which employ many people. So boys, do you know what is hydro power plants? Yes, if you go to visit Messenger, you can see that hydro power plants in our neighboring district. So hydropower plants capture the energy of falling water to generate electricity. A turbine converts the kinetic energy of falling water into mechanical energy. Then a generator converts the mechanical energy from the turbine into electrical. Now we shall know about people and culture of these states. There are about 220 ethnic groups of people in the Northeast. So you can remember how many ethnic groups of people in the Northeast. They speak many kinds of dialects. There are also people from Tibet, Burma, Bangladesh, and Bhutan who have made the Northeast their homes. Their food consists of different kinds of herbs, rice, and meat. They love wearing such a colorful costumes. Many forms of folk dance and music are practiced by the people of Northeast. Meghalaya is inhabited mainly by three types. You remember three tribes, that is Khasis, Jaintis, and Goras. Rice is the staple food of the people of Manipur. The Lepchas, Bhutias, and Nepalese are the ethnic groups of people in Sikkim. So you remember these all points for your betterment. So next we know the popular dance forms of the state. In Tripura, the dance form is Hojagiri. Mizoram, there is Chirao. And Manipur, there is, we all know, Manipuri. So these are the popular dance forms of these three states. Next, we know about the festivals of these states. In Tripura, there is a festival that is famous festival is Kharchi Puja. In Mizoram, the famous festival is Mimkut. In Sikkim, there is Sonam Lazar. And the Nagaland, there is very famous festival is Hornbill Festival. Next, you will remember this point because it is very important in this chapter. Number one is Arunachal Pradesh has around 5,000 species of plants, birds, and insects. Next one is rubber, tea, coffee, orange, and cardamom are grown in the hilly stations in Manipur. Next one is Kaibul Lamjau National Park is the abode of that rare and endangered brow-antled deer known as Sangai. Next one is Twelchang is the biggest monolith in the state. Next, the three ethnic groups of people represent a blend of three diverse cultures, traditions, and religions in Sikkim. And the last one is Phurchawsu, Yamtang, Borang, Ralang are hot springs in Sikkim. And last, you see a chart that is very important to remember about the brief description of these states. And this is, I also give you a PDF format. And you can, if you possible, you can write down in your geography copy. And from there, you can remember these points. There is also name of states, capitals, rivers, highest peak, largest lake, natural vegetation, and tourist post. So, if you do this and if you read through many times, you can a picture in your mind. And if you do this process for your betterment, you can never forget the capitals, rivers, highest peak, largest lake, natural vegetation, and tourist spot of this state. So boys, today's class is over. You at first go through the lesson very carefully. Then I shall give you some classworks and homework. You can write down the classwork in your school geography copy. And homework also you write down in your geography copy. And when the school will reopen, the subject teacher discuss or check the answer in the class. So boys, today's class is over. If you have any queries or problems, you may contact me by call or sending message WhatsApp. So, thank you for this class.